Why, hello there. It's time to learn you how to make a simple looping animation in Photoshop. Well, let's begin, shall we? All right, so to begin, we're going to go over a little bit of Photoshop's capabilities in terms of animation. So we've got a document here and a graphic that's been brought in, and the next thing we want to do is open up the timeline. So we go to Window and Timeline, and then we go down here and select Create Video Timeline. All right, so what we're going to want to do is go over here and drag the bar down to however long we want our animation. I'm just going to set this to 2 seconds for demonstrative purposes, and then we can zoom in on that. Actually, let's drag this down to 1 second just to make it easier. All right, so the next thing you want to do is expand this menu right here. We see we have 3 options for transform, opacity, and style. And we just want to click this little stopwatch icon to create a keyframe. And then because we want our animation to loop, we go to the end, create another keyframe, actually drag it to the end. And basically what Photoshop's going to do is create everything that's in between the keyframes. So go right to the middle here and create a 3rd keyframe. And with that keyframe selected, we can move our graphic over here. Then if we go back to the beginning and hit play, see that it moves from 1 keyframe to the next and then back. We can also rotate our graphic, and as we go from keyframes, it'll move and then move back. We can scale it. And we can do interesting things like transform flip horizontal, which will make it do this. And of course, if we so desire, we can do any combination of those all together. So we already have it horizontal, we can move it, we can scale it, rotate it, and it'll do all those things. Make it a little wacky. Now, if you have a point selected and you hit the button again, that will delete that keyframe. One item of note is that if you rotate an item exactly 180 degrees, it will always turn clockwise. See, it turned a full 360 instead of turning 180 and then 180 back, so that's just something to keep in mind. And if we want to remove all of the keyframes we've already put in, we can just hit the stopwatch again, and they'll all go away. And now we'll look at opacity. Once again, just click that, create a keyframe, and honestly, you can create your next keyframe anywhere, and then just drag it to the end. Then we'll create one in the center, and this time we'll go to our layer options, and go 0 with the opacity. And when we play it, then once again, we can just hit the stopwatch icon to remove all the keyframes there. And last is going to be style. Style is basically all of the things that you would find in your blending layer options. So your drop shadows, your inner glows, your outer glows, your embossing, or all the things right here in the styles panel, which is going to make it really interesting when I do that. And it just fills in everything in between, and that's about it. Okay, so here we have the actual image we're working on. Basically what I want to happen here is I want the body to bob up and down and the head and sign to both swing back and forth. So what I've done is I have separated each of those parts into separate objects, and I've already gone ahead and put in the beginning and ending keyframes. So the first thing we're going to want to do is select our midpoint, and we are going to want to go to the body and create a new keyframe, and just going to want to squish it down just a little bit. Now we're going to create a keyframe on the head and move it down so that it goes back to somewhat of a natural position on the body. And then put one in for the sign, and then move it down as well. Then we just check, make sure that all looks good. Okay, that looks good. So next we're gonna move on back to the sign. If you put the arrows next to the little square, that'll automatically take you to the next keyframe. So we want the sign to wave back and forth. So what we wanna do is take this little center point here and click that and drag it to where we want to rotate from. Because otherwise, when we try and rotate, it'll just rotate from the center. But now, it rotates based on that point, and we're going to want to put it a little bit further back. Alright. Then we're going to want to go to our keyframe for the head, and likewise, we're going to want to move this little point to wherever we want to rotate it from. This is actually a good point for me to bring up, that whenever you're going to be rotating anything, always work larger than your final image is going to be. If you don't, it will look very bad. Insert informational graphic here. Then we're going to want to rotate the head just a little bit. There we go. Go back and we'll check it out. And that looks pretty good. So what we want to do is go to File and Save for Web. All right, and then we're going to want to select your preferred GIF file type and click play, and it goes very slowly because my computer is very old. But we'll go less slowly after I size it down. Then you're going to wander down here for looping options, and assuming you want this to loop repeatedly, you're going to select Forever, which will make it loop forever. And there we go. We have a simple looping animation. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, why not give it a like? That would be rad. And consider subscribing. It's what all the cool kids are doing. Well, until next time.